Hello students, we are going to begin with chapter number 9 for class 10, subject science 1. The name of the chapter is carbon and carbon compounds. This chapter is very important. This chapter carries 7 marks with option and 5 marks without option. The topics that we are going to cover in this chapter are the covalent bonds that are formed in carbon compounds, carbon as a very versatile element, types of hydrocarbons, saturated and unsaturated, functional group in carbon compounds, homologous series, IUPAC nomenclature of carbon compounds. Then we will take up some chemical properties of carbon compounds like combustion reaction, oxidation reaction, addition reaction, substitution reaction. We will study the chemical properties of ethanol and ethanoic acid, and finally macromolecules and polymers. Let us see some questions which are based on previous knowledge. What are the types of compounds? Compounds could be organic and inorganic compounds. Now the word organic means something which pertains to life or something which is related to life. When very little chemistry was known to mankind, people thought that substances like starch, sugar, proteins, acetic acid could be obtained only from the living sources like the plants and animals. And since these substances were obtained from plants and animals, that is the living sources, the compounds were called as organic compounds. So compounds derived from living organisms are called as organic compounds. A very important point to be noted is that organic compounds contain carbon as a very important constituent or a very important element. So organic compounds can be defined as compounds containing carbon as an important constituent element are called as organic compounds. So organic compounds are those compounds which contain carbon as an important constituent. And the chemistry which deals with the study of organic compounds is called as organic chemistry. Now there are some compounds which are produced from minerals and non-living sources. So such compounds which are produced from minerals and non-living sources are called as inorganic compounds. So we define inorganic compounds as compounds obtained from minerals are called as inorganic compounds, and the chemistry which deals with the study of inorganic compounds is called as inorganic chemistry. It's very important to note that there are some of the compounds like carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, carbide salts, carbonate salts, bicarbonate salts. These are inorganic compounds which contain carbon in them. Since organic compounds were obtained straight from nature and there was no definite method known at that time of preparing these organic compounds in the laboratory, it was believed that the organic compounds were some of the products of vital forces of nature. So, in 1828, a German chemist by the name of Friedrich Wöhler showed that it was possible to prepare an organic compound in the laboratory. So the very first compound that Friedrich Wöhler prepared in 1828 was urea. Urea was an organic compound. You can see that urea is containing carbon, and this urea was prepared from an inorganic compound called as ammonium cyanate. We use many things in our day-to-day life. Things such as foodstuffs, clothes, paper, medicines, wood, fuel, shampoo, perfumes, etc. Which constituent elements are common in these compounds? All these compounds contain carbon as a very important constituent element, and along with carbon, the compounds also contain hydrogen and oxygen. The percentage of carbon in the earth's crust is very, very meager, and so also is the percentage of carbon in the atmosphere. Earth's crust contains only 0.02% of carbon, which is in the form of minerals like carbonates, hydrogen carbonates, coal and petroleum. The atmosphere contains 0.03% of carbon in the form of carbon dioxide. In spite of this small amount of carbon which is available in nature, the importance of carbon is immense. Since in this chapter we will be learning about carbon, which is an element of immense importance to us in both elemental as well as combined form, we need to know the position of carbon, the atomic number of carbon, its valency and so on. So, to which group in the periodic table does the element carbon belong to, and write down the electronic configuration of carbon and thereby deduce the valency of carbon. Now, from the symbol of carbon that is given, or you can see on the screen, carbon 6, 12, where 6 is the atomic number of carbon and 12 is the atomic mass number of carbon. So, if the atomic number of carbon is 6, the electronic configuration of carbon will be 2, 4. Since there are 4 electrons present in the outermost orbit of carbon, valency of carbon will be 4. And since there are 4 electrons in the outermost orbit, carbon belongs to group number 4 in the periodic table. So, to which group in the periodic table does the element carbon belong to? Carbon belongs to group number 4 in the periodic table. What is the electronic configuration of carbon? Atomic number of carbon is 6. So, electronic configuration will be 2, 4. And what will be the valency of carbon? Valency of carbon will be 4. Let us see some more questions. And first we will see the properties of carbon compounds. Carbon compounds have low melting point and boiling point. This is because the force of attraction which holds the molecules together is not very strong. And therefore, again, this carbon compounds have low melting point and boiling point. You will find that these compounds are bad conductors of heat and electricity. And since these compounds are non-conductors or bad conductors of electricity, the bonding in these compounds does not give rise to any ions. And therefore, the chemical bonds in carbon compounds do not produce ions. So, what are the properties of carbon compounds? Carbon compounds have low melting point and boiling point. These compounds are bad conductors of heat and electricity. The chemical bonds in carbon compounds do not produce ions. Chemical bond. What is a chemical bond? A chemical bond is a force of attraction which holds atoms together inside a molecule. A chemical bond is a, since a chemical bond is a force of attraction, we cannot see that chemical bond, but it does exist between the atoms. So the force of attraction which holds the atoms together in a molecule is called as a chemical bond. What is the number of chemical bonds that an atom of an element forms called as? This is actually a property which is called as catenation, which we are going to study very soon. What are the two types of chemical bonds? Ionic bonds and covalent bonds. You have already studied ionic bonds in the chapter metallurgy, and we will be studying about covalent bonds in this chapter. Let us study the bonds that are formed in carbon compounds. Okay. So now we know that the atomic number of carbon is 6. Electronic configuration of carbon is 2, 4, which means there are 4 electrons in the L shell of carbon atom. First shell is called as a K shell, second shell is called as the L shell. So the L shell contains 4 atoms, 4 electrons. Now every atom of an element tries to attain the electronic configuration of the nearest noble gas in order to become stable. And when is an atom said to be stable? Only if an atom has completed its duplet state or octet state. Duplet state is presence of 2 electrons in the first orbit, which is also the last orbit of the atom. And octet state is presence of 8 electrons in the outermost orbit. So carbon has 2 orbits, the K shell and the L shell. So if we consider the L shell, there are only 4 electrons in the outermost orbit of carbon. So carbon needs another 4 electrons in order to become stable and to complete its octet state. What will carbon do in order to obtain or in order to make the outermost orbit stable with 8 electrons in the outermost orbit? Carbon will have to accept another 4 electrons from some other atom of an element. Or if carbon has to obtain a duplet state, that means it has to give away those 4 electrons which are present in the L shell. So if those 4 electrons are lost, there will be only K shell with 2 electrons. So carbon will become stable with 2 electrons in the outermost orbit. So every atom tries to become stable either by donating electrons, accepting electrons, or by sharing electrons. Now, since carbon is present in period number 2, the closest noble gases for carbon are helium and neon. Now, as you can see, helium has only 2 electrons in the outermost orbit, so helium is stable by completing its duplet state, whereas neon has electronic configuration 2,8, that is neon has 8 electrons in the outermost orbit because it has already completed its octet state. So now let us see what can carbon do, whether carbon can accept electrons or it can donate electrons or it can share electrons. So we know that the atomic number of carbon is 6 and its electronic configuration is 2,4. So the nucleus of carbon will contain 6 protons. There are 6 neutrons inside the nucleus. There are 2 electrons which are revolving around the nucleus in the K shell and 4 electrons in the L shell. So this is your K shell, this is the K shell, and this is the L shell. Carbon is not stable because any atom will become stable only if it has completed its octet or duplet state. So since carbon has 2 orbits, there should be 8 electrons in the outermost orbit of carbon. So we find that there are only 4 electrons in the outermost orbit of carbon. So if carbon accepts another 4 electrons from some other atom of an element, or from some other carbon, from another carbon atom say, or from another atom of an element, say that these are the 4 electrons 1, 2, 3, and 4 electrons which are accepted by carbon. So if carbon is accepting 4 electrons, then it will form a negatively charged anion, that is C4 minus anion. Okay. And if carbon forms a C4 minus anion, then it will be very difficult for the nucleus, which is holding 6 protons. The nucleus is containing 6 protons. It will be difficult for the nucleus containing 6 protons to hold 10 electrons in the extranuclear part. And therefore, carbon cannot accept 4 electrons to form a C4 minus anion. Another option is carbon can lose 4 electrons from the outermost orbit. So if carbon is losing 4 electrons from the outermost orbit, then it will become stable because it will attain the electronic configuration of the nearest noble gas, that is helium. So duplet state is complete. But if carbon is losing its 4 electrons, then carbon will form a C4 plus cation. Positively charged ions are called as cations, and they are formed by loss of electrons. So if carbon is losing 4 electrons from its outermost orbit, then it will form a C4 plus cation. But for losing these 4 electrons from the outermost shell, it will require a large amount of energy, leaving behind 6 protons inside the nucleus and just 2 electrons in the extranuclear part. So once again, providing so much energy to remove the 4 electrons from the outermost orbit is not possible. So the possibility of carbon to lose 4 electrons to form a C4 plus cation is not possible. So what is the only option left with carbon? If it cannot donate its 4 electrons nor accept 4 electrons, the only option left with carbon is to share its four electrons with other carbon atoms.